so wrong? Why can't I get this right? Maybe the whole camera needs to move. Literally, this entire video is just gonna be me trying to get the freaking intro. We're starting. Something still don't seem right. And welcome back to my channel. For today's video, it is the second day of K-mas, and I can't believe that Christmas is literally like 2 days away. That kind of like totally messes me up. Being that Christmas is 2 days away, that also means that we're like less than 2 weeks away from rolling into the new year, and I feel like this time of year is always my favorite for that reason. Like, I am that person that gets obsessed with the new year, sets a bunch of resolutions, tries to maintain them, usually fails. We all do it, it's all good. But I love any good excuse for a new beginning, a chance to set some goals, get some organization stuff done, and basically be the inner Monica Geller that I am. Really quick, if you guys aren't following me already, I have been posting some New Year's style hints. There's a bunch of New Year's stuff coming for my channel and also just in general, so definitely come check that out, as well as my blog, right where Bentley is right now. I've been going to be posting some New Year's resolutions and goals and stuff on there too, so definitely check that out. And also, if you're wondering, is my arm cold? Yeah, yes it is. So moving forward, if you guys want to know my formula for living your best life in 2018, then just keep watching. Oh my god. Another coffee talk into which I have forgotten my coffee!
So many fluffies on me.
How frigging beautiful. Look at that steam. Also, this is a mug that's gonna be coming out on Koos very soon. Yeah, that's literally life in a nutshell. Okay, now we can begin. So when it comes to living your best life in 2018, I've broken it down into three steps to make sure that you're not only just moving forward into 2018 to live your best life, but also coming up with a plan and learning from 2017 if it was a bad year. I might be one of those like exceptions to the rule where I actually really enjoyed 2017. Based on what I've read on Twitter, a lot of people had a lot of downfalls or really didn't like 2017. That said, no matter if you think you had a good year, a bad year, whatever it is, the first step when it comes to living your best life following into the new year is reflecting on the year that just passed. How was 2017? Like, how was it really? Think about where you were January 1st, 2017. Did you look different? Were you acting different? Were you working somewhere different? Were you happier? Were you sadder? Was there things going on then that you've coped with? Were there things that you didn't even know were gonna happen throughout the year yet? Even if it seems like not a lot has changed and shifted, a lot has. Don't just try and focus on the things that you didn't like about this year. Try and ask yourself the things that you did like about this year. That way, you're not kind of going into 2018 with a really sour perspective. I feel like that's such a thing that we all kind of joke about. We're all like, oh, this year sucked. Going into 2018 with that is only going to breed more of that negativity in the new year. I think we have to come to terms with 2017 before we can even think about having a better year in 2018. What did the bad things that happened in 2017 teach you that you can carry into 2018? This is like a little mental trick where you take a negative and somehow try and find the positive. Pull out a journal, pull out a piece of paper, or just sit and actually truly take some time to reflect on 2017, on the good of 2017 and the bad of 2017. And not only that, ask yourself, what was your role in it? It can be also really easy for us to look at a year that maybe wasn't our favorite and look at all the reasons why it sucked and not really take responsibility for our own play in that. We can also then forgive ourselves for not doing the things that we wanted to do in 2017 in order to move on into 2018 and not carry that resentment. Forgive the fact that you didn't have the year you thought you were going to, solely to be able to move forward into 2018 and try better without having that self-doubt or that weight of self-loathing or blame on yourself or on anybody else. So the first step when it comes to living your best life next year is to reflect on this year. Step number two when it comes to living your best life in 2018 is to plan. And quite frankly, my favorite step in the whole process. Once you've reflected and gotten all that energy out of your system from 2017, it's time to start planning for 2018. And this is where things get fun. I know there's a lot of people that bash resolutions and say that it shouldn't just be at the beginning of the year type of thing, but I also feel like the new year just gives us like this opportunity to do it and start fresh with a clean slate, and I think that's why people enjoy it so much. I personally don't think it's overrated. I think it's what you make of it. It all starts out with three different categories: your goals, your priorities, and your habits. First things first, ask yourself what kind of goals you want to accomplish in 2018. One of my biggest goals for 2018 is to release Dreamcatcher and feel like I really took the time to do it the way I wanted to do it and get it out in a physical form and basically release my first actual book. Other goals could be things like running a marathon. It could be starting up a YouTube channel. It could be anything that is detailed where you're like, I want to do this exact thing. That is a goal. The next and quite frankly, I would say more important list to make for 2018 are your priorities for the year. When we set goals, when we set resolutions, we tend to get very lofty. We tend to get very excited and we tend to think that we have maybe more time or more energy to do all the things that we really want to do, and it sucks that we don't. But this is where your priority list comes into effect, because not only is your priority list going to help you keep on par with the things that are more important versus things that you can maybe let slide into 2019 or further, your priority list is also going to make sure that you're not losing yourself in your goals. We get so hyper consumed with accomplishing these crazy things and these crazy goals that we forget to set priorities and keep the most important things at the top of that list, like your family, your friends, the people that are important to you, your health. So that way, when you're trying to accomplish all of these crazy, lofty goals, things are overlapping, you're running out of time and you don't know which to give your all to, you can check your priority list and see what comes first. And you can put everything on that priority list. Your priority list could be 100 items long and it could start with friends and family and end with things like posting to Instagram. It could even be that simple, but making sure that you have a priority list and putting it in an order into which what is most important to you and to who you are as a person to what is maybe not as important, but something you still enjoy. It makes it so that when it comes down to spending your time with a family member who's only in town for a few days or getting done this goal or this whatever that you had planned, like working out maybe or whatever it is, even if at the end of the year you don't accomplish everything you wanted to accomplish, you know you always had your priorities straight. And the reason why you probably didn't get it all done is because you took the things that were more important in life and put your focus and your time and your energy there. Then you can go out of the year, even having not accomplished maybe everything you wanted to, feeling good at your core. Step number three is looking at your goals and your priorities and then asking yourself, what types of habits are you going to need to form in order to keep yourself accountable and on top of these things for the whole year? So for instance, if you have a goal to start living a healthier lifestyle, what type of habits are you going to need to form in order to accomplish that goal? Maybe you need to research meal prepping. Maybe you'll need to start looking into living like a vegan lifestyle. Or maybe you want to start running, start going to yoga. And then how do you plan on forming them? This is where all the research and the nitty-gritty details of your goals and resolutions for the new year come into play. If you want to write a book, if you want to start a YouTube channel, if you want to start learning an instrument, if you want to learn a new language, if you want to start a healthy lifestyle, if you want to travel the world, odds are you're going to need to research about it and then come up with some sort of strategy or plan in order to execute your goals and get them accomplished. At the beginning of the year, it's easy to jump up and be like, all right, I'm going to the gym. But once February and March starts rolling around, do you have a backup plan that's going to keep you, you know, accountable to these goals? It could be telling somebody about it. It could be setting reminders in your phone. It could be having a vision board or a mood board. If you spend a whole month posting blog posts every other day or YouTube videos once a week, then maybe at the end of the month you can invest in a new camera or invest in a microphone or invest in some lighting, because you're rewarding yourself for taking initiative and sticking to the goals and actually putting in the work. And then my last and final tip when it comes to planning out 2018, this is going to sound super nerdy and weird, but it works. Trust me. Write yourself a letter dated December 31st, 2018. Pick the top three goals that you want to have accomplished in 2018 and write out that you will or you hope that you have accomplished those by that day. Maybe some perspectives that you hope you're still holding on to, or maybe some promises that you want to make to yourself for the end of the year. So by December 31st, 2018, who do you want to be? And write to that person promising that you're going to make sure that you get there, that you get to being that person by the end of the year. Read it over a few times, put it in an envelope and seal it. And I'm saying like seal it so that you cannot open it until December 31st, 2018. And then leave that envelope somewhere that you can see it every day, whether it's on your dresser, at your desk, in your purse, wherever you want to put it. But make sure that that letter is something that you can see every day. So anytime throughout the year, that letter is a constant reminder of the promises that you've made to yourself for that year and how hard you're gonna try to make sure that you become the person that you told yourself you were gonna be. And just a quick note to keep in mind when doing this, it can be super easy to not even realize that we're leaning more into the superficial.
By the end of the year, you better have a million freaking followers or I'm gonna hate you.
That's where you gotta come back to your priority list and look at your priorities, look at your goals, and write a letter to yourself and ask, who do you wanna be by that day that is actually true to who your core is and the best version of yourself that you're striving to be. And last but not least, when it comes to living your best life in 2018, the final step is action. The thing about action is, at the beginning of the year, it's easy to have this burst of motivation and inspiration, but action is actually what creates motivation and inspiration. It's not motivation and inspiration that creates action. We're lucky because when the new year rolls around, it does come with a bit of a sense of inspiration and motivation because you feel like you have this clean slate. But as the year starts to carry on, keep this literally chiseled into your brain. Action is what breeds motivation, which comes back to action. Take the action and trust me, the mindset and the attitude will follow. Another really important thing about action is give yourself a motto for the year. A quick line, a quick word, something that you can say to yourself, and that's gonna be the motto of 2018. So any single time that you feel yourself slipping or you don't wanna take action, you say the motto to yourself and it gives you that just tiny little bolt of energy that it takes to just do it. Your motto could be Hakuna Matata. Your motto could be just do it, like Nike. There's so many things that your motto could be. If I can think of more, I'll put them in the description box. And if you guys have any mottos to add, definitely leave them in the comments down below because I feel like it'll just be like the most motivating comment section of life. But come up with a little motto and live by that motto for 2018 every single time you take action, every single time you go at life, or every single morning that you wake up. You can do all the reflecting and planning in the world, but the action is where you actually show up for yourself. This is where you stop just sitting in your comfort zone dreaming of the type of life you want to live and actually just start living it. The final piece of advice when it comes to living your best life in 2018 is to remember that life is what happens while you're busy making other plans. Reflect on 2017, plan out your year, take action, but don't attach yourself or your happiness too much onto an idea of what you want 2018 to be. Instead, let the year unravel for you and take every moment and opportunity that it gives you and just do your best and make the best out of it while also being kind and keeping your intentions and your priorities in check. And with that, we'll all be able to go into the new year without attaching to this idea or belief and instead allowing ourselves to be happy no matter what happens because we're in line with who we are to our core and making the best of every single moment. So this concludes the formula slash steps that I came up with in order to live your best life in 2018. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you guys didn't know this, one of my other big goals for 2018 is actually to turn Coffee Talks into a podcast. So if you guys have any podcast topics that you guys want me to start working on, also pop those down below or feel free to tweet or Instagram them at me. There's still one more video left in the 12 days of Camus, so I will see you guys all tomorrow. But with that, I still hope that you guys are all having a happy and a safe holiday and, you know, that you're feeling a little humbled now by 2017 and not so defeated by it because based on Twitter, it feels like everyone was feeling just a little bit defeated. Now, I'm gonna go change my sweater because my left arm is very cold. Bye, guys.